Hello friends, my name is Kishan and welcome you in this video tutorial. In this video, we will see BoneCP connection pooling example. I will show you how to create and configure a connection pool using BoneCP data source. As we know that creating and establishing database connections are relatively very expensive because of establishing a network connection, initializing data base session, authorization in the backend database, etc. Due to these issues, it is good practice to use a connection pool in your application in order to increase the performance and scalability. By using connection pool, you can reuse already existing connections and prepared statements so that you can avoid the cost of establishing the connection. BoneCP is a fast, free open source Java database connection pool library. If you are familiar with C3P0 and DBCP, then you already know what this means. So in previous few video tutorials, we have seen how we can create connection pool using C3P0 as well as Apache DBCP. DBCP is a library that will manage a database connection for you to get faster database access in your application. So to work with BoneCP, it requires some library to be added in your class path. So those library I have already downloaded, and before showing those library, let's this example I had created in previous video tutorial. So that is for C3P0 data source connection. So let's make another copy of this project with another name. I would say BoneCP data source connection pool demo, and let me close the previous example. So this is the replica of our previous demo, right? So here client program I'm going to leave almost as it is. There is little modification. So instead of get data source, here I would like to call get connection method. Okay, and utility DB util program is going to change drastically. So here, first of all, we need to add dependent library in class path. So these are the library which is required for the C3P0 connection pool. So these two library I'm going to delete. MySQL connector jar is still needed. And here I can show you to create a database connection pool using BoneCP required jar for BoneCP Guava. So let's copy first these two jars. So I'm going to copy in the leaf folder. Now you required SLF4j jar as well. So if I can extract it, let me extract. So you will have to download SLF4j jar as well. So once you extract it, then you will have to take two jar from here. First SLF4j API, and second you will have to take SLF4j JDK14, something like this. These two jar also you needed in your class path. So I have added almost five jars in lib directory. Now I need to add it in our class path. So go to the build path, then select configure build path, and these two let's remove, and let's click on add jars. Now jar is already in lib directory, so select all these four jars. Now all five jars is in class path. Now here little change over here. So in DB utility, right? So here, first of all, I'm going to write get connection method, and this is going to return connection object. And let's say, so this will give the compilation error as of now. So first of all, what I'll do, I'll comment this portion of code. And here we'll try to make use of BoneCP So there is a class, it's called PwnCP. Yeah, so that imports will happen from this jar PwnCP. And let's say this is called our data source itself for better readability. Now if you look into the constructor available in this class PwnCP, then you can say PwnCP, which accepts PwnCP config object, right? So that means first of all you need to create a PwnCP config object, right? PwnCP config object, and this PwnCP config object, let's create a constructor this class again, and here we'll have to set all required properties and that we need to pass to this constructor. So let's set the all required, first of all mandatory property, like set JDBC URL. So this JDBC URL we can take from here, now we have to set username, database username, so that we can copy from here, and again we can set password, okay. So these are property you have mandatory to set. Once you are done this, then there are lot of properties which is optional. So I'm going to set those optional properties, like set set mean connection per partition, that I'm going to specify 5. Similarly, I'm going to set max per partition, and that is going to be 100, and I'm going to set partition count, and that I'm going to set 4, right? So mean partition is 2, right? And I have stated partition count is 4, right? So that will create initially 5 into 4, 20 connections, and one partition maximum can contain 100, right? So one partition can contain 100 connections, and every partition will contain at least 5 connections. So that's the meaning. Again, I'm going to set property like set something is called lazy init, and that is I'm going to true, set true. So this flag depends on the requirement. So if you set lazy init, means when your application will get the first request, then connection is going to create, as this will not be created. So that's all we needed up to here, and now we need to return this connection, and we have data source, this is object of PwnCP, and here this class is having a method is called get connection. This guy is going to return a connection object, right? So let's press Ctrl Shift O for organize import, and let's see why this guy is throwing an error. So let's add in try catch. Sorry. Now this is throwing an error. So add existing clause. This is not needed. So remove it. And all error has been gone. Now all we are set to go. This driver you don't need to load. So from Java 6 onwards, you don't need to load the driver. Now almost we have done here. I have kept all database information, and this information just I am reading from the this properties file using properties class. Properties class is having a load method. So just I'm calling, and this load method is taking file input stream, and there I'm passing the relative path of this my property class. And using this object, just we are passing the key and getting the corresponding value, and we are setting a value. We have a, so when client calls get connection method, then data source object will be created in the static block, and from this data source we are getting a connection and returning to the client. And here in client program we are using try with resources. So here connection as statement object you don't need to close explicitly, because out of the program if you use try with resources, then it will be called by the JVM itself. Just I am selecting all records from the database using execute query, and all results just I'm trying to print. That's it. So if I run this program, so I'm getting the all results which is available in the database. So these are the records are present in this here. I have also DB script here. So if you download this code from the GitHub, then before running this application, this main program, don't forget to run this DB script. So once you run and you import this project in your Eclipse or whatever IDE you are using, once you run this application, then you must get output like this, right? So I hope you learned how to create connection pulling using Bone CP. So thanks for watching this video, and if you have any questions or queries regarding Bone DB Bone CP or whatever videos I have uploaded till late, if you have any query or questions, then please do post below to the video. I will try to answer those queries. And if you like this video, then please subscribe my YouTube channel. And thanks for watching this video.